الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين، أما بعد. قال المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى الشيخ عبد الرزاق بن عبد المحسن حفظهم الله تعالى: باب فضل التحميل والتكبير والتهليل والتسبيح. الشيخ عبد الرزاق حفظه الله تعالى في كتابه الذكر والدعاء، he brings another chapter, a chapter in which we briefly touched on the other night. I just want to review it a little bit. And that is the chapter of the excellence or the superiority and the virtue of التحميد, saying Alhamdulillah, التكبير, saying Allahu Akbar, التهليل, saying La ilaha illallah, والتسبيح, saying Subhanallah. The Shaykh brings hadith عن أبي ذر رضي الله تعالى عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ألا أخبرك بأحب الكلام إلى الله؟ قلت يا رسول الله أخبرني بأحب الكلام إلى الله. فقال إن أحب الكلام إلى الله سبحان الله وبحمده. رواه مسلم. In this hadith here, on the authority of Abu Dharr, the companion of the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, may Allah Ta'ala be pleased with him, he said that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, أَلَا أُخْبِرُكَ بِأَحَبِّ الْكَلَامِ إِلَى اللَّهِ. Shall I not inform you of the most beloved speech to Allah, the beloved statement to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? He said, O Messenger of Allah, please inform me of the most beloved of the kalam of Allah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he said, indeed, the most beloved of the kalam to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the statement, khafifatan ala al-lisan habibatan ila al-rahman, tayyib, taqilatan ala al-mizan. That this statement that is very light upon the tongue, very heavy upon the scales, and very beloved to al-rahman, to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, subhanallah wa bihamdi. Subhanallah wa bihamdi, from the most beloved of the speech to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as we mentioned, hunaka ahadith ukhra, there are other ahadith. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ahabu al-kalam ila Allah, qawlu la ilaha illallah. That the most beloved statement to Allah ta'ala is the statement la ilaha illallah itself. So how do we, Ibrahim, najma' bayna هذا الحديث والأحاديث الأخرى؟ أحب الكلام إلى الله سبحان الله وبحمده. Right? وهناك الأحاديث الأخرى لا إله إلا الله. أحب الكلام إلى الله. How do we make it as a reconciliation, huh? As we mentioned, Abdul Jabbar, take both of the hadith and do what with it? Except both of them, right? Nah, that is the way. They say that even though the Prophet ﷺ here said the most beloved statement to Allah Ta'ala, kalam, is not restricted just to this kalam here, it's other kalam. But we have a very clear hadith. The Prophet ﷺ, أحب الكلام إلى الله أربع. That the most beloved kalam to Allah Ta'ala is four. Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, La ilaha illallah, Wallahu Akbar. أحب الكلام إلى الله. And this hadith only mentions what? Subhanallah wa bihamdi. And this is an important tool for the talib al-ilm as well as for the Muslims, is that when they read a hadith, right Kareem? They don't just believe that that hadith was the end of all a hadith. The Prophet ﷺ said this is it. So now I'm going to argue with you when you come to me and I heard you in your class or your khutbah, I'll tell someone the most beloved speech to Allah is la ilaha illallah. I'm going to come to you and say, no, akhi, there's a hadith that says the most beloved speech to Allah, subhanallah wa bihamdi. What are you talking about? But the Prophet ﷺ, he also said, أحب الكلام إلى الله أربع. The most beloved speech to Allah is four statements. Subhanallah is one of them. Alhamdulillah is another one of them. La ilaha illallah is another one of them.
And Allahu Akbar is another one of them. وَلَا يَدُرُّكَ بِأَيِّهِنَّ بَدَأْتَ. And it does not matter in which one you begin with. Does it matter with which one you begin with? طيب.
وعن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى أن قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لأن أقول سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر أحب إلي مما طلعت عليه الشمس رواه مسلم. This hadith on the authority of Abi Hurayrah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said that the Messenger of Allah sallam said, for if I was to say Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, La ilaha illallah, Wallahu Akbar is more beloved to me than everything that the sun rises above. Meaning that these statements are more beloved to him than the dunya and everything that's in it. More beloved to him than the dunya and everything that's in it. This is the way of the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. This is what he taught his companions. Dhikr. More beloved to him, these words, than every single thing that the sun rises above. Everything in the dunya. And it's very easy for us to do. Very easy for us to say. طيب.
وعن أبي ذر رضي الله تعالى عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال يسبح على كل سلامة من أحدكم صدقة فكل تسبيحة صدقة وكل تحميدة صدقة وكل تهليلة صدقة وكل تكبيرة صدقة وأمر بالمعروف صدقة ونهي عن المنكر صدقة ويجزئ من ذلك ركعتان يركعهما من الضحى رواه مسلم.
We'll start with this hadith tonight. And that is on the authority of Abi Dharr al-Ghifari also, in which he said, collected by Imam Muslim in his Sahih, that for every joint that you have, يعني سلامة المفاصل بين الإظام, right? It is the joints in between the bones, سلامة. Every day that you wake up, for these joints, there is a sadaqah. There's a sadaqah. He said, every tasbihah is a sadaqah. It's a charity. Every tahmida is a sadaqah. It's a charity. Every tahleela, la ilaha illallah. We're talking about subhanallah. Alhamdulillah. La ilaha illallah. Right, Jazal? Tasbih. What is tasbih? Subhanallah. What is tahmid? Alhamdulillah. What is tahleel? لا إله إلا الله. كم عمرك؟ How are you? Nine. ما شاء الله. بارك الله فيك. Huh? Look at this. Our youth, young, 9 years old. He understands these terminologies. This is what? It's a reflection of who? The parents. ما شاء الله. ما شاء الله. تبارك الله.
So every تهليلة is a صدقة وكل تكبيرة and every تكبيرة. What is تكبير, جزاري؟
تكبيرة تكبيرة تكبير ها الله أكبر نعم. Commanding the good is صدقة. Forbidding the evil is صدقة. ويجزئ من ذلك ركعتان يركعهما من دح من الدحى. And will suffice for all of that, all of those تسبيح and تحميد and تهليل and تكبير, is to make 2 ركع صلاة الدحى. Right? 2 rak'ah, salatul duha, before what? Before what? Before dhuhr. طيب? Before zawal. Right? Zawal of the shams.
We will stop here, bi'idhnillahi ta'ala, tonight. In these little short sittings, what is hoped from them is that they be an encouragement for us to become more practical in our religion, in our adherence to Al-Islam. Practical. Say subhanallah. Say alhamdulillah. Take time out when you're driving, when you're walking, when you're sitting still, when you're not doing anything. And you remember, make dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As we just mentioned in the verse in the Quran, we recited Surah Isha. فَذُكُرُوا كَمَا عَلَّمَكُمْ مَا لَمْ تَكُونُوا تَعْلَمُونَ. Remember Allah. Make dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَذُكُرُوا كَمَا عَلَّمَكُمْ such as he has taught you, ما لم تكونوا تعلمون. has taught you what you did not know. Right? Many verses in the Quran that encourage us, as we mentioned previously, already to make dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us amongst al-dhakirin, al-dhakirin Allah kathiran wa al-dhakirat. We ask Allah ta'ala to make us, ourselves and our families, our females amongst our families, our wives, our daughters, our mothers, all of them from amongst our families, to make us amongst those who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala much, and make us mina musabbihin, make us amongst those who make tasbih of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, alhamidin, those who praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are the types of people we want to be. Mukabbirin, muhallilin. We want to be these type of people that keep our tongues moist, right? With the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because in the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is what? Tatma'inul qulub. The hearts find rest and the hearts find satisfaction. Not drugs, alcohol, women, medication, movies, music, anything. It's not where the heart finds satisfaction. The heart finds true satisfaction in the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahu ta'ala a'lam. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.